Don't be surprised that you're seeing me here today. Okay, so it's been about a month plus. I mean, a month and 2 weeks that I've been using the Starlink. I told you guys that I'm going to be showing you speed test. I'm going to be showing you data usage and some other things. So, being 1 month plus, I've been able to get a TP-Link router that I use to connect the other side of the house. I'm going to show you exactly where I mounted the router, the Starlink router outside. Being a Starlink Mini, the router is mounted inside the dish. So the distance you have from the dish will throttle down your network or your Wi-Fi speed. So I've been able to get a router here that serves every other part of the house. And I'm going to be showing you how I got that done, I mean, by myself. So let's just go through it. And I'm going to be showing you, in case you don't have the money to buy an extra router, I'll show you what you can use to solve this problem. So this is where I mounted the Starlink router. This is my office window. And so I got an L-shaped bar for the router outside. Now, looking at the house from the side, this is the side view. Now, if you stay at the dining side or in the kitchen, which is about, let me say, about 50 meters away from here, that's a distance. And so you will not be able to get speed as, in fact, sometimes you will not even see this router on the other side of the house. You won't find it on your phone. The Wi-Fi is off. So that's why I had to get, you will see that there are two cables. Normally before, it was only one cable that was coming out. So that's the power cable. But now I have the CAT cable, that's the LAN cable that goes inside. And so that is what goes directly into the router I was showing you the other time. So let's go right into how I was able to do it and the other things I want to tell you in case you don't want to buy an extra router. I'll see you inside. So from outside, I was showing you that the LAN cable came inside. And so this is the LAN cable going into the asbestos, I mean inside the roof, and then coming down in the living room that I showed you the other time. So now that is going to serve my TP-Link router outside. And so the TP-Link serves as the extender for the Starlink router or Wi-Fi that is built inside the Starlink dish. So it serves the whole house. So this side is accounted for. That other side is accounted for. It connects to my fridge, it connects to my freezer, my pumping machine, and some other devices like that. So it helps the whole house to work on the same network. And one other thing is that there is this thing called the mesh network, so, or mesh system. So when you are connected, for example, if I'm inside the office, my phone will connect to the Starlink router because that's the closest and that's the strongest as at the time of connection. So it is close and it's going to be fast. So the system tests, the mesh technology will test to see where you are closer to. So if I move to the living room, automatically the phone or the device you are holding with you will connect to the router in the living room. So that is how it works, and it works perfectly fine. There's never been a time that you will say, oh, this thing is not working, what's going on, and things like that, unless if it is off. So that's how that guy works. Now, also, I said I wanted to show you how you can use any of these guys to use them as the router. You don't want to buy a TP-Link router, you don't want to buy an extra router. You can actually use these guys if you have them. If you have the MTN or the Airtel router already available, I'm going to show you before I end this video. But quickly, let's look at the speed test and the payment I've made so far using Starlink. This is my Starlink account on the website. And so as you can see, the balance due for today is 0.00 naira. And let's go to subscriptions. We'll be seeing other things. So let's click on active. We'll be able to see. All right, so this is what I've used so far. For the month of June to July, I activated June 4, and to July 3rd, I used and consumed 1.17 terabyte. It's an unlimited data and it's pretty okay. So I actually use it over and over and over again. I use it for streaming, and so it is serving. At least the fact that they will not cut you off before the due date of your payment is amazing. So August, that is July to August. So from July 4th till now, today is July 18th. So to today, so this is about, I've used 733 gig so far, and still going and still counting. So that's quite amazing. So now let's look at the payment I have made, the payment I've made so far. And so you see about three invoices, but the three invoices, let's split it now. So we have the payment and the credits. The payment I've made, I made payment when I purchased it on 2nd of June. That was 354,300 naira. That was the payment I made. And also, I was charged on July 4th, 2025, for my first subscription. Now, my first subscription that I made payment for. But you know, if I activated it on 4th of July of June, that means this payment is for the one. So it was a credit. They gave it to me free of charge. So this was a credit given to me by Starlink themselves. And so that was why I was telling you guys that the first month is free. And from here, you can see that there is no activation fee. I don't know. I researched about it and I discovered that I was seeing activation fee in some places. But when each time I try to place order for it, I don't see it. So if you want me to place the order for you and just put your address, I can help you with that. So I paid 354,300 the first month free, and then I made payment this July, 57,000 naira for this month payment. So that's it so far, and then it's been quite amazing. Let's look at a speed test quickly and see. Let me reload this page and then we'll do the speed test together, so that I will also test it on the phone for you to see the differences between each of these speed tests, whether it's faster on the phone or it's faster on the system. Let's go. Okay, you will allow it to. So this is about 27 28 29 and 26, like that. So this is what you get, but then sometimes it is far higher than this, it is higher than this. And one thing I've discovered is that it works fine. Look at my upload speed. This is about 32. In fact, the upload speed now is even moving higher than that of the download speed. And I stream to Facebook, to YouTube, it goes fine. I watch videos a lot and it works absolutely fine. So it has been serving and I can say I'm enjoying it very well. So that's that about that. So this is 26.55 megabit per second, and the upload is 25.39 megabit per second. So I think we should do that test also on phone. So here on my phone, this is what the speed test looks like. Let's do that together. I'm connected to the Starlink router, and so let's see. Okay, beautiful. This is about 140 something, almost the same minutes, just few minutes away. This is 116 118, and peaking at 130 something. So the upload speed is 23.55 thereabout. So this is what we get on the phone, 119 23.5. now if I decide to connect to the router that I have in the living room, now this is the closest here, but I can choose that I want to connect to the router, the TP-Link router outside. So let me try it and then connect to it. So, and we will do a speed test again. So doing a speed test again, let's see. All right, this brings it down. So because I'm far away from that router, and so it's giving me about 21 point something as upload, and let's see what it will give us as download. 20.8 as upload and download, and 25 as upload. Amazing. So roughly around 20 something. You can change your plan to business plan if you want, but I think I'm okay with this residential. It gets the work done and I don't have stress over it. At least I'm not frowning my face as regards my pocket again. These guys are not ripping me off anymore. So I think I'm fine with it, and it's really going well. So that's that about the speed test. And as you can see, I've paid them only twice for the purchase of the hardware and then the subscription this month. I didn't pay for that of last month. Amazing enough. So I said earlier that you can use any of these routers as your broadcaster. So instead of buying an extra router, you can actually use any of these guys to power your whole house if it is far. For example, so someone was saying that he stays in a two-story building or thereabout. So you can send this one up and one serves down. So just connect it and change the IP address and the subnet mask, and you are good to go. I think ChatGPT can help you with setting it up if you want to use any of these guys. So I will also drop a link for you to see one or two things of, I mean, the settings you will need to set to get this guy working for you. So far, so good. This has been my experience with Starlink within the space of 1 month plus now, and I can say I have enjoyed it. These guys are no longer my problem. One of them, I will mention their name, this red guy, they called me some days back and they were telling me that I should please subscribe, that even if it is 2K, urgent 2K, that I should subscribe. But there's no way I'm going to subscribe for this again. So maybe I'll just sell it. I will sell one, I will leave one, based on popular advice. If you want to buy, I can ship it to you, and it's available for sale. Thank you very much. I'll see you again in the next video. You can drop your comment as regards your experience on the Starlink router so far, if you have gotten your own. And if you have not gotten your own, I think this is your green light to go get yours. All right. So I'll see you again in my next video. Subscribe and please share this with somebody who is about to buy his own device. Thank you. Bye.